towards the East Coast now, where snow is blanketing homes across western New York, with cars and streets nearly buried. It is going to take a while for folks to dig free.
That's right. Katherine Bundt, who lives in Buffalo, joins us now. Katherine, can you tell us about your experience from start to finish with the snow and what you and your family went through?
Well, actually, we were quite lucky compared to other people in the area. Probably about midday Thursday, my husband made the decision to go to his parents in West Seneca to spend the holidays there. We actually thought we might be able to get out on Sunday, but our area, we're in the South Towns. We didn't tend to get the blizzard effects that the North Towns got. I have relatives that live in the North Towns, and they said it was 24 hours of just blizzard conditions. So we kind of hunkered down where my in-laws live in West Seneca. We just now got back to my house today. I don't know if you can really see this, but there's my house. Mm. And then my car is over here. And of course, the snowbanks, again, they're as tall as me. So we are digging out. It looks like we do still have power. So we actually came out much luckier than a lot of people in the city did.
Oh, that is some good news there. Now, walk us through what it's like to dig out such an intense, or not that in case, but for your neighbors. Are they prepared for a blizzard like this? Is this something that we heard you say you made the decision on Saturday? Is that something that a lot of your neighbors maybe do in terms of a blizzard like this?
I feel like kind of looking around the area, it seems like the majority of them stayed put and hunkered down. The reason we made the decision to leave was because we wanted to try to spend Christmas with family. So that's why we made the decision we made. But it looks like here, for the most part, people have been shoveling out. So my assumption is they are pretty well prepared. And really around here in our neighborhood, we are always helping each other out. When we had that 5 feet of snow, we had neighbors come over and help Mike and I, because it was just, as you saw a few weeks ago, quite a bit of a mess. So,
Katherine, is there any way you could pan your camera around just to show us? Because I think I've been seeing what looks like a snowblower in the background at times where your vehicle is.
That is my father-in-law. My in-laws, my husband had to work today, so he wasn't able to come and help. That's my father-in-law's vehicle. You can see it's kind of up there. He had to try to park in the street, but kind of away. And then you can see, this is actually, when we got here today, my mother-in-law and I we started shoveling, and we actually made some pretty good progress. We can't physically get in my house yet, but we're going to start work on that as soon as we get done here. But yeah, my father-in-law, he came, got the snowblower going, and you can hear him, so.
And you mentioned your husband had to unfortunately go to work. How was his progress getting to work? Has he explained that to you just yet? Have you gotten into contact with him?
No, but I did drive the same route he would take getting into work. And he fortunately drives main roads, and he works in Orchard Park. They had their travel advisory lifted quite early. I don't think they got really the snow. I'm in Lakeview. We got, when I was looking at the measurements, about 41 inches of snow. And then we got more snow on top of that yesterday. So I think we got more of the brunt of the lake effect. And then, Mike, it seemed like he got to work no problem just because I saw the route he took. So
nice.
How relieved do you feel having that snowblower as opposed to the snow shovel?
Oh. I cannot tell you how much. I mean, I'm going to give a shout out to my in-laws again. They have been godsends, you know, letting us stay at their house for longer than what we all thought would be. Mm-hmm. And the snowblower has been helpful. I mean, my mother-in-law and I are trying to shovel out. And if I don't have the world's best biceps now, I will soon, because it's a lot of work trying to shovel out. Literally, when I got here, it came up all the way up to, I mean, you saw the picture of my thighs, and you saw probably the thoughts I was having when that picture was taken. So,
well, we're so relieved you have a easier way to clean up. Make sure the in-laws get a break every once in a while, though. I'm so happy they're there helping you. We appreciate you joining us today on Fox Weather, though. Please be safe.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies. Have a wonderful day.
Thanks.
Same to you.
I'm Amy Freeze. Welcome to Fox Weather's YouTube page. We have more great videos on the way, so make sure to subscribe to stay updated on all things weather.